A health facility without a drugstore, enough bed capacity, staff quarters, as well as a mortuary. This is the story of ailing Changwali Health Center 4. Sometimes dead bodies spend days in the wards before they are disposed of.
We are mixing pregnant mothers with sick mothers, those who have just delivered. Then we do not have a drugstore. If you can have a drugstore, then this can be extended to create more space. Then the other issue is also about a mortuary. When a commissioner, we have challenges where some people are abandoned here, and when they lose their lives, it becomes hard for us to dispose them off.
Due to the challenges of space, about 200 mothers under the postnatal ward are being managed under a tent, and the situation is worse given the current weather. Dr. Tom Ediamo, the acting director of Hoima Regional Referral Hospital, says the situation at the facility is nerve-wracking.
I can look at maternity ward, they are the tents, okay? What I call the maternity or what it was not, I don't want to call this tent the maternity ward because it's a disgrace. And to me, really, the biggest thing I can go with when somebody has understood is we don't need that thing here. So all the partners, or maybe the government, whoever, help us, the medical fundraise for people to donate and have a permanent structure there.
This one is not good for their health because any of our pregnant woman is very difficult to handle. So we agree that we can be transferred to other wards, so that those other patients who are not very bad off can at least be put in the tents. But these ones who are going to what we are thinking we can call post-operation error can be put in the ward.
The Commissioner for Reproductive Health at the Ministry of Health, Dr. Richard Mogahi, promised that the government will restore sanity at the hospital.
I think there are those small areas that we need to pick up. We've noted the issue of inadequate supply. The quality of care, that was operative thing of yours, cannot be emphasized. And in trying to generally maintain high quality because of the numbers, you have to get away.
The facility has been boosted with a neonatal care unit by Baylor Uganda, and it is fully stocked with two neonatal incubators, two radiant warmers, each with two oxygen cylinders and three baby cots, in a bid to respond to the rising number of neonatal deaths in the area.
The onus now is on you. For us, we've done our part. We've handed over the facility to you to manage it. MTI, even next year, the rich facility here with land titles. Please, we don't want to come back here and in 1 year.
Changwali Health Center 4 serves over 17,000 people from the community and Changwali Refugee Settlement Camp. Meanwhile, over 1,000 patients in Nigang and surrounding areas have received free treatment in a medical camp organized by Faith Babies Home in partnership with specialized doctors from USA.
Can't read well when, more so when I'm in like a dark kind of place. I need a so much light for me to read. And I'm happy that I've got this. It will help me.
The director of the organization, Grace Kaziba, highlighted on the success of the camp.
This is the third day of the camp. We had the first day in Navidia in Iganga, the second day in Bugweri. We serve the people of Bugweri. Today is the third day we are serving Faith Babies Home, the people of Iganga. The turn-up is very big. So far, the 2 days, we got around 1,000 people.
Our children, they are going to get free medication, whereby our women, they are going to get free medication. Our husbands, they are going to get free medication.
Faith Babies Home, it has helped us as government, me as a probation officer. Whenever I get calls of abandoned, abused, and vulnerable children, I know where to place them.
Report compiled by Godfrey Mohomoza and Ivan Wachibi for the news.